Rakim Allah, the God MC. It's widely agreed in hip-hop circles that Rakim is the best, if not one of the best, MCs of all time. He's one of the few MCs to emerge out of that third generation of MCs and still get the props from the first generation originators. In various conversations over the years about lyricists in hip-hop, it's almost a given that Rakim's name is gonna come up as one of the best. But my main problem with these lists, these top 10 lists, these personal top 5, these magazines and TV programs who come out with the top 10, top 20, top 50 MCs of all times, is that the people who make the list, either they're using little to no criteria at all, or the criteria which they base these lists upon is based on either popularity and record sales, personality worship almost, how cool the MC is, their output, how long their discography is, and even the perception of how financially successful they are. That's why I find it nearly possible to have these conversations with people about lyricists, because everybody has a different criteria and everybody looks for something different in the MC in question. For myself, the first thing that I consider is poetic value, as the great Kumo D likes to talk about. Poetic value is very important. How poetic? What poetic techniques are employed within the MC's delivery? Rhyme structure, cadence, all these things are important. Additionally, for myself, I have to consider, what was the condition of the genre when this MC entered, and what was the condition of it after they left? In other words, how did they affect it? Did they change anything? Did they inspire others to change their rhyme patterns or improve their game on the mic? I would have to say Rakim scored extremely high, if not off the charts, in all of those previously mentioned categories. So what was the state of the game when Rakim came in? In 1986, we witnessed the incredible 12-inch single, Eric B is President, with his B-side, My Melody. We were just off the heels of groups like Grandmaster Melly Mel and his faction of the Furious Five with Step Off. The Treacherous Three with their single, Gotta Rock. We were still seeing successes from Houdini, the Fat Boys, and that whole Fresh Fest lineup. Of course, a year or so before, Run DMC had just dropped Raising Hell, a groundbreaking album. But stylistically, what was new lyrically? Had anybody come with a new style? T. La Rock was still releasing a strong string of singles on Fresh Records with Mantronic. And in a year or so, we were about to see a whole new scene come in. Of course, LL was still going strong, but nobody had really come up with a style and cadence and rhyme pattern that changed the whole game in quite a while. I've maintained since witnessing Rakim's greatness that there's three things that made him a top-tier MC. And the first was his rhyme patterns. The way he patterned his rhymes and the scheme of his sentences was something that had been dabbled in before, but never mastered and taken over the top until he did. Secondly was his flow. Once he structured the sentences, the way he made the rhymes flow with his cadence. And lastly was his ability to paint images very vividly, especially on a song like Follow the Leader. Instead of just saying like any other MCs, I'm the best, I'll take you out, you know, I'll beat you in a battle, he employed very, very imaginative vocabulary and scenarios that made you picture what he was trying to say, but in a way that was so far beyond the rudimentary way that other MCs had described taking out another MC. And we'll get into that in a minute. But I have to be chronological and give you the groundwork and give you the history on where this came from, because this style didn't just come out of the sky. And Rakim admits that he was influenced by people like Grandmaster Caz, Grandmaster Melly Mel, and Kumo D, amongst others. So let's start with the sentence structure and how it had been along before. Most MCs will rhyme the last word of each sentence in a very basic way as far as their vocabulary and cadence. And this always kind of bothered me as an MC early. And I mean early, like early 80s, I always felt like we're going to run out of things to talk about. We're going to run out of words. And I was a young person thinking this, not really thinking that, okay, you know, the words are not necessarily infinite, but our experiences are infinite. So we'll always have something to talk about. But what bothered me was the way that we were confined in how we talked about it, the structure of the sentences. But you could see early on in the stylings of somebody like a Grandmaster Caz, who predates Rakim at least by 10 years, that there was a style going on, but everybody didn't get a chance to see that. Unless you were, you know, blessed to be in the places where this music was being performed, you did not know that people were structuring these sentences this way. So for instance, a word like environment, there's not really a word that really rhymes with environment in a way that's not cheating when you rhyme the word. I was listening to Caz recently on an interview, and he said he would never rhyme digital and criminal because it doesn't really rhyme. He said it's cheating. So there's a rhyme that Grandmaster Caz said, and he used the word environment. And instead of rhyming it with one word, he took two words to make it rhyme. So he said something like, I look at my environment and wonder where the fire went. Now, right now that may not sound like a big deal to anybody because it's been done several times over the decades. In fact, that style is still a very prevalent style amongst MCs right now. So it doesn't seem like a big thing. But at the time, that was kind of the key to unlock a new thing, a new paradigm, a new flow. Because this thing that I said that we were confined in, where we couldn't really speak and utilize words to their maximum, he was breaking it apart at that time. So to say, I look at my environment and wonder where the fire went, you're unlocking a whole new realm of possibilities on the microphone. And there are other instances of Caz using this technique, but that's one of the better ones that I can think of right off top. Kool Moe Dee was another one who utilized that style early on, maybe more so than anybody else. If you look on the back of Kool Moe Dee's debut self-titled album, on the special thanks, you'll see thanks to LL Cool J, T La Rock, and Rakim for breaking my style of rap through. That was not ego or arrogance when he said that. He really did employ those styles very early on. If you listen to the flip side of Gotta Rock, which was a 1985 song by the Treacherous Three, the flip side is called Turn It Up, and it was really the birth of Kool Moe Dee's solo career. There's a line when he said, I wanted to put you on a trance, make you dance, like you're in a coma, cause you tried to go home a moment too slow, and now you can't go. Okay, again, coma, there are words that rhyme with it, aroma, there are other words. But again, he took one word, coma, and put two words together to rhyme with it. So he says, you're in a coma because you tried to go home a moment too slow and now you can't go. And then he goes on into another whole rhyme pattern. It's very Rakim-ish. And the funny thing is that when I say this to people, because they're more familiar with the Kool Moe Dee from, you know, maybe Go See the Doctor, but definitely from How You Like Me Now and, you know, I Go to Work and some of the more commercial records that he made, you know, with Jive Records, they look at me like I'm crazy when I say that. But if you go back to the DNA of this, and the history's all there on the records, and that's the root of that. There was another line on that same record where, Turn It Up, where Moe Dee said, even if I whisper, I'm always louder than any other rapper, and they'll say, how the hell did he do that? Then say, who's that? Rhyming, smoking, Moe Dee's not joking. That whole cadence was something that really hadn't been done before, but people didn't pay as much attention to Gotta Rock. It was on Sugar Hill Records, on the last legs of Sugar Hill about to go out. LL was hot. You know, that whole next school that had come out, you know, back in, you know, the first part of the 80s, 83, 84 was still hot. So it really didn't get examined to its fullest. Even when Moe Dee started to really get big on the solo tip with Go See the Doctor, he employs this technique an awful lot in this song. And I caught this early on. He said one line, he said, I'll put it down if you want me to put it. But don't blame me if it turns into a foot extended from the middle of your body. I mean, he rhymed put it with foot extended. I mean, that's next level. He's doing something very poetic at that point. And, you know, we were bopping our head to the beat. I think that was a Teddy Riley beat, and it was a catchy song. So we may not have really recognized the lyrical complexities going on in that song. But he said, I'll put it down if you want me to put it. But don't blame me if it turns into a foot extended from the middle of your body. And the next time you see a cute hottie, you won't be able to screw. The only thing you can do is just kick her. So go take karate. So what about this cat Rakim Allah? Well, he came in with the multisyllabic flow right off the top. He said, it's biting me, fighting me, inviting me to rhyme. I can't hold it back, I'm looking for the line, taking off my coat, clearing my throat. Rhyme will be kicking until I hit my last note. My rhyme remains divine, all kind of ideas. Self-esteem makes it seem like a thought took years to build. Again, just a few years before that, we were just rhyming the last word of each sentence. And Rakim is rhyming words in the middle, the last word, and then coming back and taking it back to a previous word. Again, the groundwork was laid, but he just took it to another level right off the first single with Eric B. as president. On that same 12-inch record with My Melody, he did something real slick. He said, turn up the bass, check out my melody, hand out a cigar. I'm letting knowledge be born and my name's the R. Usually a rhyme would stop right there and you would start a new flurry of rhymes, but he connects on. My name's the R, A-K-I-M, not like the rest of them, I'm not on the list. Catch what I'm saying, I drop science like a scientist. The rhyme flow was crazy. The rhyme flow was crazy complex, and it was about to get more complex.
More complex from one rhyme to the next. Eric B be easy on the flex. I've been from state to state, followers tailgate. Keep coming, but you came too late, but I wait. So back up, regroup, get a grip. Come equipped, you're the next contestant. Clap your hands, you want a trip. The price is right, don't make a deal too soon.
So as much as I like to go chronological, it's so many Rakim lines that have been in my head since he said them that I can't even really organize them in a chronological fashion. I'll just put them out there. As far as taking, like I said, one word and then making a couple of other words rhyme with them, that style that I told you that Mo D and Kaz really had mastered early on, and other MCs may have as well, but those ones stick out. On Lyrics of Fury from the Follow the Leader album, he said, I sit back and observe the whole scenery, then nonchalantly tell you what it mean to me. Because as far as scenery, there's just not a lot of words that properly rhyme with scenery.
I sit back and observe the whole scenery, then nonchalantly tell you what it mean to me. Strictly business, I'm quickly in this mood, and I don't care if the whole crowd's a witness. I'ma tear you apart, but I'ma spare you a heart. Program it to the speed of the rhyme, prepare to start. Rhythms out of the radio.
On the Paid in Full album, there's a song called As the Rhyme Goes On. He said, I'm the R, the A to the K I M. If I wasn't, then why would I say I am? He also, on the same song, he said, the only time I stop is when somebody drop and then bring them to the front because my rhyme's the oxygen. That's just an unorthodox way to make those words rhyme, because you're not rhyming words. You're rhyming oxygen with stop and then. You're rhyming three words with one. And then after he does that rhyme, the flow after that is crazy.
When that's why they're going home to tell a friend when the party end. Yo man, you know Rakim, that brother struck again.
Going back again to My Melody, he said, the moral of the story I tell will be, nobody beats the R, check out My Melody. Again, rhyming tell will be, three words. The moral of the story I tell will be, nobody beats the R, check out My Melody.
To explode, I keep the mic at Fahrenheit, freedom season, make them cola. The listener's system is kicking like solar as I memorize, advertise like a poet. Keep your
let the rhythm hit them again. The R is accurate, plus I packed it with educated punchlines that I have to hit. We're getting ridiculous at this point because he's rhyming the word accurate with several other multiple words behind it.
Your body is where you feel a pain. That time is up. You've been hit with something different, isn't it? Rakim is gonna radiate. Nothing's equivalent. Nothing can harm me. Why try and bomb me? You couldn't look around with Rob with a arm.
Revisiting as the rhyme goes on. If you just keep kicking, listen to the mix, and then you'll sink in the rhyme like quicksand.
Holds and controls you till I leave. You fall deeper in the style. It's hard to breathe. The only time I stop is when somebody drops and then bring them to the front. Cause my rhyme's the oxygen. Then wave your hand when you're ready.
Let the rhythm hit them. Simultaneously, like a Uzi, nothing can bruise me. Lyrics that other brothers say don't move me.
Reload quickly, and you better hit me. While I'm letting this BP get with me. You're stepping with 007, better make it snappy. No time to do your hair, baby. Brothers busting at me, beats and bullets pass me, not on target. They want the
follow the leader. I can take a phrase that's rarely heard, flip it, now it's a daily word. I can get ill in an arm, a killing bomb, with no alarm, Rakim will remain calm.
Self-esteem make me super superb and supreme. Before a microphone, still I fiend. This was a tape I wasn't supposed to break. I was supposed to wait, but let's motivate. I wanna see what can keep.
Brothers try and others die to get the formula. But I'ma let you sweat, you still ain't warm. Again, going back to that, he rhymed formula, which is another word that is just not very easy to rhyme things with formula. I'm gonna let you sweat, you still ain't warm. You a step away from frozen, stiff as if you're posing. Lyrics of fury. Suddenly you feel like you're in a horror flick. You grab your heart and wish for tomorrow quick. Music's a clue when I come, you're warned. Apocalypse now, when I'm done, you're gone. Now in that instance, he's not taking one word and then rhyming several with one. He's rhyming several with several. Suddenly you feel like you're in a horror flick. You grab your heart and wish for tomorrow quick. Music's a clue when I come, you're warned. Apocalypse now, when I'm done, you're gone. Again, we dealing with some really, really clever, poetic techniques on this microphone. Now, others did it after him. Everybody did it after him that was trying to be lyrical. You would even hear Kane say, I give your girl a kiss of death just like a vampire. Stump out MCs just like a campfire. I'm not saying that Kane did anything, but I'm just saying, after Rakim and his style came to prominence, especially after the Paid in Full album, the paradigm had changed. He changed the whole rhyme structure and the cadence of the game. The greatness of Rakim has to be taken in the totality of what it was before, because again, he didn't just fall out of the sky with this style. You know, it had been done before. But what makes him even greater is the fact that he took the what had been done in an almost rudimentary way before him, and he added on to it and change the whole game with it. Now, that's the rhyme structure, the rhyme pattern. Now, as far as flow, people didn't really talk a lot about flow before Rakim. You always had flowers on the mic. I tell you, my good brother Jalil from Houdini brought to my attention the Ecstasy was a flower. And he said, yeah, Ecstasy's a flower. He said, you know, the people that flow, whether they know it or not, they're rhyming in a musical way, almost according to the musical scale. And I'm thinking about Ecstasy, and I'm thinking about discos don't open till after dark, but it ain't till 12 when the party really starts, and I always had to be home by 10, right before the fun was about to begin. Or the words love and life both have four letters, but they're two. Things all together, cause I've liked men and ladies in my day, but just like the wind, they've all blown. The nuance is in the voice. So you could be a cat that's got, you know, the lyrical miracle type, you know, big word style, but do you flow with it? So there were flowers, but nobody was calling it flow until Rakim. In fact, Rakim said, my unusual style will confuse you a while. If I was water, I'd flow in the Nile. And that's how the rhyme flow. It was like that. Follow the Leader, again, probably his best overall record when you look at impact. Everything that I've talked about to this point is in that record. But what he said on one portion, he said, music mixed mellow maintains the make. Melodies for MCs motivates the breaks. I'm everlasting, I can go on for days and days with rhyme displays that engrave deep as x-rays. I could take a phrase that's rarely heard, flip it and that's a daily word.
Rakim will remain calm. Self-esteem make me super superb and supreme. Before a microphone, still I fiend. This was a tape I wasn't supposed to break. I was supposed to wait, but let's motivate. I want to see what can keep following and swallowing. Taking the
now, almost any Rakim song is going to contain flow. So I can't spend as much time on his flow as I did on the actual structure of the words. But I really felt like the structure of the words is something that we might hear on a certain level, but it's not registering with everybody perhaps. And I say that based on the fact that when I have discussions with people about MCing, and perhaps because I'm an MC myself and I've been doing it for a minute, and these are things that I look for and utilize in my own rhymes. When I'm having conversations and people tell me these are the top three, these are the top five, and the few times these days that I engage them and say, well, why? I don't get enough of a why. I approach lyricism from a scholastic point of view. I look very much for sentence structure, rhyme pattern, cadence. You know, the beat, of course, is important for a hit record. But as far as a rhyme, for the rhyme writers, and those are checking for the rhyme writers, we're listening for technique. Now, the vivid telling of a story, the painting a vivid picture. Not a lot of people can do it. Biggie did it very well. Kool G Rap does it extremely well. I don't mean just telling a story. Slick Rick is a great storyteller, and he does it well, but just on a different level, because almost everything with him is a story, and you can visualize the story, but just on a whole nother level with Slick Rick. He's in his own box that nobody can penetrate as far as storytelling. But with Rakim, he's able to paint vivid pictures using vocabulary that's far beyond the average MC. Like I said, everybody was on that, you know, LL was one of the first cats to come around just talking a whole bunch of shit about battling. You battle anybody, I don't care, you tell. I'll do this, I'll do that. You know, cut creator, sharp as a blade. He can squeeze a dry sponge and make Kool-Aid. You know, all kind of crazy metaphors. LL is one of the best, of course. But Rakim rarely told you, I'll beat you in a battle. I'll do this to you on the mic. You know, I'll have you doing this. Rakim would rather say, follow me. And while you're thinking you were first, let's travel at magnificent speeds around the universe. What could you say as the earth gets further and further away? Planets are small as balls of clay, astray into the Milky Way, worlds out of sight. Far as the eye can see, not even a satellite. Then turn around, stop and look. You stare in the darkness your knowledge just took. So keep staring, soon you'll suddenly see a star. You better follow it, cause it's the R. He went cosmic on you. He's telling you that he's better than you. He's even telling you that he has more knowledge than you. In fact, he's taking you to 33 degrees, cause he told you you're a step away from frozen. Stiff as if you're posing. Dig into my brain as the rhyme gets chosen. Rakim influenced the whole game. Even whack rappers that weren't even lyrical, we're trying to employ some of them techniques, especially that first technique that I mentioned. So, for you know, I didn't mean to get that long-winded on it, but when I talk about lyricists, you know, that's one of the few things that gets me that animated. And when you talk about Rakim and maybe a handful of others, I'd never talk about top three lists and top five lists, because, you know, if it don't mesh with somebody else's top three or top five, we at a point where people act like you're not legitimate. All right, so this is your man Jayquan. This is foundation lesson number 13, why Rakim is the God MC. I hope you found it, if not educational, at least entertaining and intriguing. Feel free to comment. And you can reach me at thefoundation.com, thafoundation.com, to view the website. You can click on mobile and see the mobile website. Right now, I got more information on the mobile website than I do on a desktop, but that's going to change very soon. And you can hit me up, Jayquan, J-A-Y-Q-U-A-N, at thefoundation.com for email. And all social media is Jayquan V-A. Peace.
The saga begins, my eyes is the photography lens. Properly push pens and show quality gem. The harvest be grim, but yo, maybe tomorrow we win. If we follow the trends and keep count of the dollars we spend. I want a mahogany bench, I want lottery in. I want property friends, plus my hobby is skins. If I get sloppy and sin, then my prophecy ends. But the garter begin, watching my odyssey spin. In a place where war be, based on a true story. Territory was made for me to pursue glory. Blast alone, masses and zones have to be sown. Every capacity blown, I'm internationally known. Yo, so all hail the honorable. Microphone phenomenal, persona is invulnerable. Trust me, son, I continue like a saga do. Bringing you the drama to allow you that the chronicle was just begun. Begun. The saga begins. Show control, rock him, set it all. Yep, yo. The saga begins. Still say a rhyme after the next one. The saga begins. Show control, rock him.